on December 14th. Well, Lindenwood in the road blacks with a gold trim, the gold numbers, and the white lettering. Nebraska with the red letters, red numbers, and the white jerseys. Getting set to tip it away. It's Alexis Markowski and Brooks Coffey. Brooke Coffey, excuse me, as the Huskers control the tip. It's Britt Prince at the top of the key for the Huskers. As they get into the offensive set, Hake surveying for options. Quickly up top to Coley. Back outside to Prince. A high ball screen from Markowski and swings it over to Nisley, and that pass way too hot to trot. Possession will go to the Lions.
Good idea there by Logan Nisley. There was a little bit of a mismatch. Markowski got on the inside of her defender, but Nisley just with a not so great pass.
It's Michaela Cunningham controlling it at the top for the Lions. Quick edge by Markowski. Swing over to Brooke Coffey. Skip pass to the corner for Wernley. Back up top, Brueggemann. Now to Cunningham. Backs it out with 10 to shoot. To Odom at the pinch post. Dump down pass inside. That one stolen away by Logan Nisley. Nisley pushing ahead for options. Back up top to Coley. Looking inside at Markowski. Couldn't find the lane for her. Prince in isolation against Cunningham. Good defense there by the sophomore. Here's a dribble attack from Hicks. Stop and pop. And that one just off the front of the rim. No good. A couple defensive stops for the Lions.
Good try there by Callan Hake. Just couldn't get it to fall.
Here's Wernley. Back up top to Brueggemann. Calling for the high ball screen for Odom. Gets it to her in the pinch post. Guarded by Markowski. Take the handoff. Odom now to the elbow on a back cut to Wernley up with the deuce, and it falls. And Lindenwood opens up with a two-point advantage.
Good back cut there by Greasy. Wernley just got lost. Logan Nisley and Britt Prince just got lost trying to switch.
Nisley gets the switch on Coffey. Up top, Markowski lets the triple fly. Much too strong for everything, but Logan Nisley on cleanup duty kisses it off the glass for two.
Offensive rebounds big for this Nebraska team. They gave up a few too many, according to Amy Williams, in their win last week, but turned it around and found some themselves.
Cunningham over to Coffey. Back up top to Odom, working through her in that pinch post area. Dribble handoff to Wernley. That one poked away by Nisley. Possession kept by the Lions. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. They got to work quickly. Odom fakes a handoff. Brueggemann heaves a three, and that one banks off the window and falls. The Lions have a triple.
Good defense there by the Cornhuskers. Lindenwood just getting lucky on that last second shot.
Post touch to Markowski, dribbling in, trying to find a pass. No look pass up top. That shot swatted. Nisley collects the loose trash. And a joust underneath, trying to find the loose ball. Possession will stay with the Huskers, but stout defense so far by Lindenwood.
Yeah, good defense. Way to close out there on that Logan Nisley three. She's going to look to shoot quite a bit tonight. They can close out on her and keep her quiet.
Out of bounds taken by Hake. 20 seconds here for the Huskers to work the offensive possession. Prince in the corner, guarded by Cunningham. Blows by Hurt. Gets the hoop and the horn. Britt Prince will head to the line with a chance at an extra.
Yeah, the foul there by Brooke Coffey. Not a super intentional foul there. Just caught her hand at the end and sends Britt Prince to the line for a chance at a three-point play.
Britt Prince, an Adidas All-American in 2023. Good numbers from the line this year, 88.2%. And she adds the extra and completes the unconventional three-point play. We're all knotted up at five. Lindenwood and Nebraska, five each, with Cunningham at the ball at the top of the key. Swing to the corner for Coffey. She works against the very lengthy Coley. Coffey trying to find options now up top to Wernley. With a head fake, goes into the body of Hake. To the corner for Cunningham, lets it fly. That one just short. And the rebound collected by Markowski.
Markowski, only one in the area for that rebound there. Lindenwood needing to maybe crash the lane on shots a little bit.
Great job in the passing lane by Justice Odom, and she's able to swipe that one away. Here come the Lions on the break. Cunningham slowing the pace, gets it over to Brueggemann, their leading scorer, and a miscommunication there. Prince tries to collect it, and we have an over and back call against Michaela Cunningham. So a miscommunication there offensively for Lindenwood.
Yeah, Britt Prince chasing that ball down, forcing that over and back call, and rewards her team with the ball.
Alyssa Nielsen, the sophomore from Bixby, checks into the game for Lindenwood. With 6:35 left to play, we're all knotted up at five here in the first quarter. Prince heavily pressured by Cunningham. Big theme of this Lions defense. Love to play some man pressure. To the corner for Hake with a head fake. Dips it inside. Markowski can't handle the hot pass. That one's taken away again by Lindenwood. Here comes Wernley, decides to slow up the pace of the offense. A high ball screen from Oda. Wernley on the drive, and that one gets rejected. And sent out of bounds by Alexis Markowski. Lions will get the possession on the baseline.
Markowski doing a good job there. Saw the screen, slid off that defender, and was able to help out Callan Hake there in the lane.
Maya Scoff, the sophomore from Bellevue, Nebraska, will check in for Gracie Wernley as Alberti Rindahl and Allison Widener check in for Callan Hake and Britt Prince to give them an early reprieve. 6:15 left to go in the first quarter. And a high pass inside. It goes to Nielsen. Back out to the corner. Brueggemann wants a post touch for Odom. Fakes the handoff up over the right shoulder and kisses it in softly. Lindenwood leads by two. The Lady Lions finding some early offense.
Odom with the matchup against Coley there instead of Markowski took full advantage.
Back up top, Nisley head fakes at the three. Euro step into the lane with a soft touch, able to drop it home. We're all even at seven.
Nisley there had every defender in the lane thinking she was about to pass that ball, and nice finish at the rim.
All knotted up at seven, 5:40 to play here in the first quarter. Over to Nielsen, deep on that left wing. Pinch post for Odom. Fakes it a couple of passes, looking for an option. Brueggemann comes free, able to collect it. Nielsen will fire the long triple. That one much too strong for everything, collected by Markowski.
Lindenwood taking quite a few shots beyond the arc here early in this game.
Up top to Rindahl, working on the ball screen from Coley. Trying to find the roll. Back outside it goes to Widener. Penetrates, hangs and fires with the left hand, no good. Rebound collected by Markowski, and she left it just short.
Markowski getting involved in the lane again. Another offensive board for her. We talked about that record she's chasing, but doing a great job staying in the lane and staying big.
High hands, Cunningham works through it. Nielsen will try a second triple. That one doesn't hit anything besides the backboard. And a foul on the floor will keep possession with the Lions of Lindenwood.
I think Lindenwood's maybe just trying to force a few too many shots here. This Nebraska defense is doing a great job pressuring them and forcing them to make some poor decisions.
That'll bring us to a media timeout. Lindenwood throwing some early punches. We'll see if the Huskers can find
Justice Odom down there. And this Lindenwood defense has forced Nebraska to turn the ball over.
And they forced some rough shots. Nebraska shooting 33% from the floor already. We talked about the offensive rebound, but they only do so much if you are unable to put them into the basket. That's been the problem. The Huskers haven't finished the easy chances.
Yeah, not converting on second chance points when you're right under the rim would give them a bigger lead here in this first quarter.
So out of the timeout, Huskers bring out Kendall Moriarty, Kendall Coley, Petro Bojan, Allison Winder, and Alberti Rimdahl. For the Lions, it's Maya Scoff to inbound. Up it goes to Alyssa Nielsen. And back out to Michaela Cunningham. Into the corner for Ellie Brueggemann. With Mariah Stewart patrolling the lane as the center. High ball screen from Stewart as Coley hounds away at Cunningham. Only five to shoot. Brueggemann's got to find a shot. Step through, just hoists a wild one, and that doesn't find anything. The rebound collected by Petra Bojan.
Bojan getting that ball off the leg of Mariah Stewart down there, kind of getting lucky.
Bojan tees up the triple, too strong. Offensive rebound for Coley. Bojan with a euro step and a euro finish. And she kisses it in for the Huskers' first lead of the game.
There's those second chance points we're talking about. Bojan crashing the board after that shot allowed her to score those 2 points.
So here it goes for Nielsen. Now up top to Stewart directing traffic from the bench post. Stewart into the corner it goes for Scott. Homecoming of sorts for her as she drives into the lane and puts that one off the left side of the rim. No good, but she collects her own rebound. Reverse scoop is able to fall. Nifty English there for Maya Scoff.
Maya Scoff fighting through quite a few Husker defenders down there.
As Kendall Moriarty sneaks that one up and in, Huskers restore the 2-point advantage.
Lindenwood just not transitioning back quick enough, and Kendall Moriarty taking full advantage and getting to the rim.
Back up top it goes for Nielsen on the drive. Tries to put it up through contact, and there's a whistle on the floor. Going to be two shots for Alyssa Nielsen.
Moriarty trying to step into that lane there and just caught the side of Alyssa Nielsen and will get called for that foul.
And Lindenwood's an aggressive offensive team. already on the season, has had 20 free throw attempts four times this season. So a team that loves to be aggressive into the lane and hunt extra shots at the charity stripe.
Yeah, the freest shot you're going to get all game. So if they can get there 20 times, give themselves a good chance here.
Nielsen dribbles him at an 80% clip. She takes the first one as Brooke Coffey set to sub in for her should she complete the two-point chances. And she does. Cans them both. Brooke Coffey checks in after some productive minutes from Alyssa Nielsen. And she'll get her second stint. Will Coffey. Amaya Hargrove in now for the Huskers. She inbounds to Allison Widener. Full court pressure by the newly checked in Alea Wilson. To Rimdahl. Back over to the right wing for Widener. Hard screen from Bojan. Widener slices to the lane and kisses it off the glass for two. Excellent drive from Allison Widener.
Yeah, dodging through like three defenders there on Allison Widener. That help defense for Lindenwood just wasn't there, and Widener takes full advantage.
Widener trying to force Wernley away from that middle of the floor. Now back up top to Scoff. And she's in a bit of trouble here, finally gets it out. Scoff backing it out, only eight to shoot. High ball screen, hedged there by Bojan. Kick over to Coffey. Wernley will try the corner triple. Nothing but nylon for Gracie Wernley as the Lions lead by one.
Good movement by Wernley in the corner to get herself some space and put up the three.
Rimdahl pressured, skip pass to Moriarty. Waiting on a screen from Bojan, rejects it and goes into the lane up with a right hand, and that one's blocked. Hefty hand from Maya Scoff, able to swat that one out of bounds. Possession will stay with the Huskers. 16 left on the shot clock.
Good job by Scoff to stick with Moriarty and stay with her, and then she went up and got the ball.
2:23 left to play here in the first quarter. The Lions lead by one, 14-13. High pop pass to Bojan. They go inside to Amaya Hargrove, and she tries to muscle that one through contact to no avail. Ball tapped around. Who's got it? It's Lindenwood off the leg of Amaya Hargrove.
Good play there by Brooke Coffey to get it off the leg of, I believe, Kendall Moriarty and get the ball back.
Here's Alea Wilson handling the ball against Allison Widener. 2:08 left to play. The Lions protecting a one-point lead. Skip pass from Coffey to Scoff, and into the corner on the pistol action for Wernley. Fighting against heavy contact, and she just threw it away. And it looks like possession will stay. It was going to stay with Lindenwood. After a correction, possession will go to the Huskers as Kendall Moriarty hits the bench for the freshman Britt Prince.
Wernley looking a little frustrated there. Wanted a foul call, I believe, and then her teammate cut to the basket and was not there for the pass she thought she had.
So Britt Prince trying to inject some offensive life. Huskers need it, down by one. Up top to Hargrove. Looked at the triple. Back to Widener. Over in the corner for Prince. 15 to shoot. Prince trying to find her way into the lane. Quick dump down pass for Bojan. Couldn't handle it. And another turnover by the Huskers. The Lions handsy in the passing lanes.
Yeah, the Lions crowding that lane right now. Britt Prince is trying to force a pass to Petra Bojan there, and Lindenwood comes up with it.
Wernley over to Coffey. Now to Scoff. Back up top for Coffey on the fade play. Inside to Stewart, and a foul will stay on the floor. Looks like Petra Bojan grabbed the jersey of Mariah Stewart. Let's send it to the third member of our crew, Harmon Johnson. Looks like we'll have to wait on that one. We'll keep it with us for a moment. And you can see Olivia Petra Bojan getting another foul, playing physical on the interior.
Yeah, both these Lindenwood players, Mariah Stewart and Justice Odom, being physical in the lane, and it's causing the Huskers some havoc.
Hard drive by Scoff. That one too strong. Huskers looking to play fast in transition. Prince has to slow it up, out to Rimdahl, looking for the touch to Bojan, and she seals off Stewart and finds an easy deuce.
Stewart trying to go out and get that ball and create another turnover, and just got a little bit too out in front of it, and Petra Bojan lays it in.
Over to Coffey, now over to Scoff on the wing. Back to Brooke Coffey, driving against Amaya Hargrove, and it looks like Widener got a piece of that. Wilson with a jumper too short off the front iron, and the possession will go to the Huskers. Substitution here for the Lions. Gracie Kelsey gets her first action for Mariah Stewart. So already three post players through the rotation for Lindenwood.
Allison Widener all over the place there on that defensive end, trying to create turnovers for her team.
As Britt Prince working, 37 seconds left on the first quarter clock. Rimdahl with a head fake working against Wernley. Bojan tees up the long jumper. That one no good. And a rebound trying to be corralled by Hargrove. And it looks like Nebraska will maintain possession on the baseline.
Hargrove crashing the board there on that three from Bojan. And Nebraska's rewarded with the possession.
They've had to fight for it. Lindenwood hasn't scored in 2 minutes and 14 seconds. Hasn't mattered. They've already forced four turnovers. Lob play inside. Bojan. And it looks like she took a couple extra steps. A travel against Petra Bojan. And the Lions have an offensive possession with a game with a shot clock off and 25 and a half seconds to play in the first quarter.
Bojan just getting a little bit of ahead of herself there. And another turnover for the Huskers. Lindenwood really capitalizing on those turnovers so far.
So Huskers open up in a press as Scoff heads to the bench. Five turnovers now for Nebraska after the travel from Bojan. And the Lions trailing by one can find the best shot on the board as they try to close out this first quarter on a very positive note. Cunningham heavily guarded by Prince. As Cunningham working off the screen from Kelsey. Now trying to bull her way into the lane, and a traveling call will go against Michaela Cunningham. So a couple of extra step calls against both of these teams as more of a feeling out process taking place, Olivia. No team can really seem to get their footing offensively.
Yeah, and that turnover there, credit to Britt Prince for sticking with Cunningham that whole time at the top of the key. Wasn't giving her anywhere to go with the ball and forced to travel there.
Foul will go against Michaela Cunningham. That's her first personal of the game as she was just pressuring Britt Prince. 4 seconds left, 3-2-1. Prince has got to find a shot kick to Bojan. Don't know if she got it up in time, and she left it short anyway. So Nebraska able to hang on in that first quarter off an early Lindenwood fight. Coming up, we'll see if Lindenwood still has some punches left in the tank or if Nebraska could find a way to pull away. Unable to register any points. Four rebounds. She leads all players there in that category, but she's been unable to be effective in the scoring column.
Yeah, Markowski's just being clobbered in the lane there. Mariah Stewart and Justice Odom are doing a great job staying with her, not letting her get position, and those outside shooters are unable to get the ball inside and kind of give her an opening.
Well, Gracie Wernley with 5 points leads all scorers on the floor. Logan Nisley trailing for Nebraska. She's got the high with four. The Lions open up with possession here in the start of the second quarter. It's Michaela Cunningham handling the ball for Lindenwood. And an immediate trap in that high elbow area. Wernley able to force her way through. As Brueggemann fires the triple and cans it, and there's an away from the ball foul. So I wonder if the triple will count. Waiting to see that decision. Either way, Brueggemann canned the triple on a late closeout from Markowski. So the foul will go against Callen Hake. Away from the ball will negate the shot. And Lindenwood will keep possession on the baseline, 9:48 to play here in the first half.
Yeah, kind of unfortunate. I think Lindenwood would rather take the three than the foul there.
Well, looks like they're going to get the three. They count it away, and Lindenwood gets to keep possession. So now the Lions lead by two here early in the second quarter. Odom at the pinch post. Swings it over. Brueggemann just heaves one wildly. Found nothing. Coffey on the reverse, able to find the glass for two. The Lions have a 4-point lead inside Pinnacle Bank Arena.
Brooke Coffey noticed that shot was maybe not actually going to go in the basket and followed it up. I think they had more time than they realized, and Brooke Coffey finished it off.
Ellie Brueggemann tips that away. The Lions have opened up with a fervor here in this second quarter, playing with a ton of energy, Olivia.
Yeah, they came out hard in the first quarter, and they're continuing that into the second. A couple of games earlier this season, they scored not as many points as they would have liked in the first half and then had a better second half. So this is a little bit of a change here, playing as strong as they are right now.
Prince in and out. She lost the handle on it. Another turnover. Give Nebraska 6 for the game already. A frustrating point of emphasis for Amy Williams.
Britt Prince just trying to make things happen and maybe just doing a little bit too much here. Needs to give her offense a chance to set up and then maybe take it to the lane, see what Markowski's got going on.
Wernley waiting on the back cut, gets it to Coffey. Back to Wernley on the fade play. To the corner for Cunningham. Driving in, trying to work against Nisley. Extra skip pass and a head fake from Wernley. And a tie up there in the middle. We have a jump ball. Possession goes the way of Nebraska. So finally able to flip the tide on Lindenwood after a strong start from the Lions.
Yeah, the Lions moving the ball really well on offense. Nebraska struggling to keep up, and that's why we're seeing so many open shots by the Lions.
Petrie out, Coley in, as the senior comes back and gets more minutes for the Huskers. Putting some good minutes defensively early in the first quarter. As Hake with the ball at the top of the key gets into the offensive set. Lob pass inside. It's much too tall for Markowski, and the seventh turnover of the game for Nebraska, as some of these post passes, Olivia, just haven't found the mark. Some bad angles.
Yeah, that's the second time from Nisley to Markowski there. Got to maybe work on that pass a little bit. I think Markowski did have some good positioning, and Nisley just misfired.
Coffey finally able to get it in, almost got the five-second call. Now it's Cunningham into the offensive set for Lindenwood as they lead by four with 8:26 left to play. Cunningham swing to Odom. Now up top for Brooke Coffey. Coffey to Brueggemann, working off the screen, back to Coffey. Wide open dribble from the right wing, that one too strong. And a rebound fought for and controlled by Callen Hake. Here come the Huskers pushing the break as Hake now gets into the offensive set, trying to set something up. To the wing for Britt Prince. Markowski, dribble handoff, gets it over to Logan Nisley, drives in, scoop with a right hand, way too strong, and a rebound for Lindenwood. It's Cunningham.
Nisley just charging into the lane there and wasn't able to control it herself enough to put up a good shot.
That one much too strong off the hand of Maya Scoff, and here come the Huskers in transition, and an errant pass from Britt Prince. Scoff on the breakaway. She's going to have a wide open two and able to cash it in. 21-15, Lindenwood leads this one by six. Sloppy play early from the Huskers.
Maya Scoff from Bellevue, Nebraska, just about 40 minutes up the road, so I'm sure it's a pretty cool experience for her to be here.
Bit of a homecoming for her. One of the leading scorers at Bellevue East High School. Markowski, the turn and the fire count, the bucket and the foul. Markowski finds a deuce to get the Huskers within four with a chance for an extra at the line.
Yeah, Justice Odom just playing really physical down in the lane with Markowski. It's been the reason Markowski struggled to find points tonight, but that time just playing a little bit too physical.
So Odom picks up her first personal foul as Markowski heads to the line. She's had her free throw struggles this year, only a 57% free throw shooter, and she misses that one long. The offensive rebound fought for and corralled by Britt Prince. What effort there by the standout freshman.
Yeah, Britt Prince makes such a great impact on this team. Had quite a few turnovers so far early in this game, though. Needs to slow down, maybe try and control the pace a little bit more instead of trying to force passes to Markowski and drive herself in the lane.
Lindenwood with four points off turnovers. That's the deciding margin right now, is 4 points between the Lions and the Huskers. As Widener pressured at the top by Brueggemann, gets into the lane. Dump pass for Markowski, and she's hacked again, and will head to the line for a couple charity shots. Another foul there. That one will go against Michaela Cunningham. That'll go against Justice Odom, actually, her second.
Two quick fouls there for Odom. She's going to take a seat. That should give Markowski a little bit more space in the lane. And defensively, Markowski's been having to work really hard. And so that transitioning to offenses, she struggled a little bit more.
Markowski misses the second free throw attempt of her day long. And 1 for 3 on the day. 2 points, 4 rebounds. She's been very quiet in the scoring column, and a large part of that due to the defensive strategy of Lindenwood. As Markowski goes 0 for 3 on her 3 free throw attempts, and the Huskers still trail by 4.
Yeah, and when you're going to get to the line, you got to take advantage here. 3 missed from just Markowski. That put Nebraska within 1, so something you definitely want to take advantage of.
Brueggemann working against Hake. Back up top to Scoff, working against Coley. 12 seconds left on the shot clock. Somebody's got to get open. Scoff kicked to the corner for Cunningham, working on Prince. Cunningham into the lane, fighting through a couple of bodies. No whistle right there. Clean block from Markowski.
Cunningham just not strong enough to get through the hands of Alexis Markowski in the lane.
And off to Prince, working against the screen. Now a dump pass. Markowski tees up the triple. On the top of the key, that one too strong. And we have a foul away from the ball that'll go against Nebraska.
Britt Prince seeming surprised by that call there. Gets called for the push, trying to chase down that rebound. Looks like she got her elbow into her a little bit there, so that'll be a foul against Britt Prince.
First personal of her day, second personal for her, the third team foul against Nebraska.
Yeah, Nebraska needing to minimize some fouls and some turnovers here if they want to creep back closer to Lindenwood.
Lindenwood three team fouls, Nebraska with two as Alyssa Nielsen has the ball, kicks it over to Scott. Now up top, Brueggemann, he's a long triple and drains it. Ellie Brueggemann from way downtown.
She is not afraid to put it up. We've seen her put a couple up near the end of the shot clock, but that time with plenty of space, plenty of time, and still decides to get it up there.
Right inside to Markowski, she's fouled again, and will head to the line for a couple bonus shots. More physical play, this time the foul will go against Gracie Kelsey from Agency Missouri.
See if Markowski can take advantage of this trip to the line.
As Markowski nails her first free throw attempt of the day, 1 for 4. That's good for 25% for the math majors at home. 15 points, 7.9 rebounds, 2.1 assists. Productive campaign as she goes 1 for 2 at the line for a player who was picked preseason first team all Big Ten, Alexis Markowski. It's Cunningham at the top of the key. 5:42 left to play here in the first half as Coley able to poke that one away. More length affecting Lindenwood, but it hasn't affected them too much, Olivia, as they find themselves up 6, 24-18 over the number 25 Nebraska Cornhuskers.
Yeah, I think they've done a really good job staying calm against this kind of frantic Nebraska defense. Allison Widener is usually all over the place. Kendall Coley with some really long arms and getting in the passing lanes. Lindenwood turning ball over there. But
as Gracie Kelsey tried her best ballet act, couldn't quite keep the balance on the tightrope and stepped out of bounds. Going to inbound, gets it to Hake. Huskers need some offense quickly. They trail by 6 with 5:32 left in the first half. Coley back over to Hake. Pump faked at a 3, now to Rimdahl. Driving along the baseline. Finds Markowski in the soft spot of the zone. A trap down on the baseline. Coley tees up the long 3. That one much too strong, but the rebound chased down by Allison Widener. Hake will tee up the triple. Bullseye! Callen Hake cashes in the right wing 3. Huskers cut it to 3.
If Callen Hake and some of these other Nebraska shooters can get going, we'll see a lot more offensive production from them. Lindenwood's really guarding the paint.
As Hake goes up into the body of Maya Scoff, and that layup attempt comes up just short on the takeaway from Callen Hake. Here come the Lions in transition. Nielsen back to Scoff as they slow up the tempo now. Smart play there from Lindenwood. Up to Kelsey. As we get into the offensive set, Brueggemann looked at a 3. To the corner it goes. Scoff tees up the triple. Looking for the response. It was too strong, and a rebound corralled by Alexis Markowski. As Widener pushes ahead, looking for Rimdahl, weaves her way into the lane, kisses it up off the glass, a bit too strong, and the rebound again for Lindenwood. So the Huskers have knocked on the door, haven't been able to quite open it.
Yeah, quite a few of those just rims out. Markowski with a handful, and then Callen Hake and Alberti Rimdahl with 2 back-to-back. Just can't get shots to go in.
It's the easy ones you got to hit to make up the deficit, and they're trailing by 3. Could use every one of those layups. Kelsey now on the handoff, 8 to shoot, just tees up the lefty, triple and cans it. Gracie Kelsey from Agency Missouri. How about that triple there?
Yeah, just shot with confidence there. Had a defender in her face and went up and over her and sank the 3.
Her first 3-point attempt of the year, and she cans it as Coley lines that one up a bit too strong, and the rebound again to Gracie Kelsey. Now Scoff will line up another triple, and she buries it. How about Lindenwood with a 9-point advantage on the road?
Yeah, Nebraska offense not transitioning to defense, and Maya Scoff is like, I'll take an open 3.
Skip pass to Rimdahl. Pump fakes against Brueggemann. Looking for a pass. She's in trouble. Now to Coley at the top of the key. Long, long bullet pass to Widener. Able to bump a defender away. Hake trying to relocate. 10 to shoot on the shot clock. Hake up with the left hand, takes the contact and finishes. Strong answer from Callen Hake.
Yeah, strong answer is right. Not a lot of threes falling for Nebraska right now. Looking to get in the lane, and Callen Hake doing just that.
And a double dribble will go against Lindenwood, and Michaela Cunningham, as Amy Williams was screaming for it. But nonetheless, the Lions of Lindenwood have come in and established a 7-point advantage. Coming up, we'll see if Nebraska can shrink it before the half here on Big Ten.
Yeah, all 9 of those points coming from the 3-point line. So Ellie Brueggemann's going to put it up. Nebraska's going to have to find a way to get a hand up and maybe force her to shoot from somewhere else on the court. Long 2s and forcing passes.
So before the timeout, it was a double dribble from Michaela Cunningham, and now the Huskers reset. 2:52 left in the first half. They got to find a way to cut a 7-point deficit. Amaya Hargrove trying to help that. She bobbled the ball and gets it back out to Alberti Rimdahl. Prince resets, 15 on the shot clock. As Britt Prince working over a screen against Alea Wilson. Hake, step back, Jack on the way. That one a bit too strong off the side iron, and possession will head the way of Lindenwood.
Callan Hake shakes a defender and unable to sink the three there, but gave herself some space, gave herself a chance, wasn't able to finish it.
It's Brooke Coffey, Alea Wilson, Gracie Wernley, Maya Scoff, and patrolling the middle is Mariah Stewart for Lindenwood. Hake, Hargrove, Prince, Beauchamp, and Rimdahl for the Huskers. It's Stewart looking for the handoff to Brooke Coffey. Coffey back to Stewart. And good ball movement here from Lindenwood, taking a long possession. Stewart, short jumper, just air-mailed it. And a rebound there for Callan Hake as she tries to push in transition. Long stride, and she got hacked on her way to the rim. And probably a smart foul there from Alea Wilson to stop what would have been a wide-open layup for Callan Hake.
Yeah, Callan Hake had all the room in the world to get to the lane there. So Wilson just slowing her down, going to force her to make some free throws here.
Huskers in the bonus as Lindenwood has 5 team fouls. Callan Hake, she had 16 in the last game, including 5 three-pointers. As she misses that first one, too strong. Free throws have been a big problem. Huskers have not been able to convert at a great rate. They're 2-for-7.
Yeah, and with those 5 points, they would be within one possession game here. So Lindenwood sending them to the line a couple times, but Nebraska unable to capitalize.
As they miss another, and then Hargrove on the rebound blows the wide-open layup. So miscues all over the place as Wilson drives in, trying to force that one a bit too strong for everything. And a rebound to Rimdahl. Huskers push quickly. Here comes Prince. Quick pass to Beauchamp. High touch, and she's able to get 2 back. Huskers cut it to 5 on the fast break.
And that's the pace we talk about. That's going to help Nebraska get back into it. Sometimes I think they try to push that pace a little too far, and it creates a lot of chaos for their offense.
Mariah Stewart, and that pass is intercepted by Amaya Hargrove. Her dad played NFL football, and she's able to find a takeaway there. Hake on the whip pass to the corner. Extra to Rimdahl. Pump fakes at it, driving into the lane. Back up top, Hargrove tees up the triple and puts it a bit too long. Lindenwood controlling the glass so far, and they slow up the tempo. And with 1:05 left to play here in the first half, second quarter, they lead by 5 to the Lions. Wilson content to just drain the clock as we find ourselves under 1 minute. Skip pass to the corner for Scoff. Working against Hake, and an offensive foul will go against Maya Scoff as she ducked the shoulder. And we talked about Hargrove's dad playing NFL football. Scoff tried to do her best Derrick Henry impersonation with that stiff arm.
Scoff trying to create some space, get herself to the basket. Callan Hake did a great job getting her feet set, getting her hips in front of her, and she'll get called for the foul. Scoff will.
So an offensive foul that will not send anybody to the line during the bonus, but it will flip possession in the way of the Huskers, and they need it, trailing by 5 here in the first half. To Hargrove it goes, and Coffey jumped the wrap and took the pass away. Another turnover for the Huskers. It's Wilson. Now inside it goes to Kelsey, working against Hargrove, trying to spin her way, and that looks like an offensive foul. Going to go against Gracie Kelsey. Extended that forearm deep in the post.
Not forcing anything, and the offensive foul gets called.
So the Huskers with the shot clock off at 28.9 seconds to cut this to a one-possession game. Lindenwood has 4 turnovers in the last 3 minutes and 7 seconds, and that same exact time frame, they haven't managed to score a point. So it's been rough sailing, but Lindenwood has really buckled down on the defensive end. As Britt Prince gets it across the time stripe, over to Rimdahl, Huskers looking for a crisp offensive set. 18 to play. Screen from Beauchamp to Nisley. And now Britt Prince controls the ball, drags Wilson out to the timeline with 11 to play. Fade play. Nisley lines up the triple. That one too strong. Rebound for Beauchamp. And look what she found. Petra Beauchamp cuts it to a one-possession game as Alea Wilson will just dribble it out as the half comes to an end. Lindenwood with a strong statement.
Against Nebraska right now. And her team's just playing gritty and playing physical.
They're going to need to keep up that physicality for 20 more minutes. Nebraska, only 1-3 on the ball game, 10% from beyond the arc, and 9 turnovers. Amy Williams will see what kind of adjustments she made in the halftime locker room. As we open it up, Lindenwood leading 30-27 as the Lions open up the ball to start the second half. It's Michaela Cunningham off a screen from Justice Odom over to Brooke Coffey. Now down to Odom. A long pass, that one taken away. Prince with a long outlet to Callen Hake on the breakaway, and a great start for the Huskers. They cut it to one right out of the halftime break.
And there's those turnovers we're talking about. Lindenwood with 12 now, and Nebraska capitalizing, getting those points off turnovers now where they had missed a few layups late in the first half.
Cunningham to Gracie Wernley, now to Ellie Brueggemann. She leads all scorers with 9 points. Up top to Odom, guarded by Markowski. Big Ten All-First Teamer last year. Now to Brooke Coffey on a high hedge from Markowski. She whipped it away to nobody, and it found its way to Cunningham. That one's swatted by Coley and put back up by Gracie Wernley. So multiple bodies in the area for Lindenwood. The Lions clean up the deuce.
Gracie Wernley just right under the basket, ready for an offensive rebound.
Prince loses the handle on it, trying to find some help. Up top it goes to Coley, the safety option. Back to Prince, gets the switch on Brueggemann, over to Hake. Driving into the lane, dump off pass to Markowski, up with a right hand, that one too strong, and the rebound by Justice Odom. So from point blank, Markowski has not had a great night.
And Markowski with the opportunity there, and too strong off the glass.
Yeah, Brueggemann tried to put that one off the window from the corner, and Markowski able to corral the rebound. She chases her way to fourth in the rebound, all-time record for Nebraska, if she can get two more. It's Hake back up top. Markowski unable to handle the pass. She's had trouble with a couple of those tonight. Prince, stop and pop, pull up jumper, and she puts it too strong for everything.
Yeah, this Nebraska offense kind of headed by Markowski and Prince, and both of them struggling a little bit more tonight than we typically see.
So it's Cunningham, pressured by the freshman Prince. Cunningham played at Spire Academy. Home of LaMelo Ball and former four-star recruit Rocket Watts. Over to the corner for Wernley on the triple. And that one takes a hard bounce off the back iron. Rebound by Markowski. Here come the Huskers on the break. Nisley with a head fake. Back up top to Markowski. She resets the offense. Hake looking for a ball screen from Coley. Just buzzed the triple anyway. And she cans it. Callen Hake with another triple. And it levels the Huskers and the Lions at 32.
Yeah, two threes in 385 consecutive games. And Callen Hake sinking that one from deep, shot it with confidence over her defender.
Cunningham tried the spin, no dice there as that one tapped out of bounds. A good spin move from Cunningham. And like you said, they've had two threes in 385 consecutive games. They've hit a three in 506 consecutive games. So Nebraska, potent from beyond the arc. They always find a way to get their threes in.
Yeah, and Callen Hake, one of those primary shooters, had 5 threes in their win against UMKC last week. If she can get going, this Nebraska offense is going to see a little bit more success.
She leads all scorers with 10. Nisley trying to open up another three, and that one can't go. Prince with a stop, shoot-around jumper, and she's unable to get that one to fall. And after the rebound spot, four possession will stay with the Huskers.
And Prince with almost too much time there, too much time to think about it, leaves it short. But luckily, the Huskers will get it back.
Something you shoot in the practice. Markowski with 8 rebounds has tied herself for fourth, and Prince finds herself an easy deuce. Huskers restore their advantage. They're up 2.
Good cut to the basket by Prince there, and Kendall Coley finding an open shot, giving Prince a chance.
It's Wernley being trapped by Prince. Long skip to Coffey. Another long skip to Wernley. Gets the screen from Gracie Kelsey. Now over into the corner it goes, and a deflection from Callen Hake. Possession stays with Lindenwood, 11 on the shot clock.
This Nebraska defense being a little bit more aggressive here. We see them finding passing lanes and stripping the ball, and Lindenwood on a 2.5-minute scoring drought here. So Nebraska defense really stepping up early in the second half.
As Leah Wilson checks into the ball game from Michaela Cunningham. Trying to find Brooke Coffey. Coffey drives in, physical move, and she draws the foul from Kendall Coley. We talked about it early in the first quarter. This is a Lindenwood team that loves to find their way to the free throw line.
Yeah, Kendall Coley trying to keep up with Brooke Coffey there, couldn't do it. Reached back and caught the arm of Coffey on her way up. It's going to be a foul every single time.
Just As Coffey, the first one too strong off the back iron, and Nebraska leading this one by two. Coffey, 2 points, 2 rebounds, 1 for 2 from the field tonight. And a lot of her impact has been felt on the defensive side, as she's able to split the difference, go 1 for 2, and cut the lead to 1.
Britt Prince, again, leading this offense. If she can get going, Nebraska will see more success.
Long skip pass to Hake. That one can't fall again. Huskers can't find the range from 3. Only 2 for 12 on the ballgame. Make it 2 for 13. Wernley driving in physically against Callen Hake and draws the foul. That will be Hake's first of the ballgame.
Wernley with a shot fake had Callen Hake off balance. She stood up, didn't stay low, and then catches her on the dribble to the basket.
So an out-of-bounds play here for Lindenwood, trailing by 1, 6-11 left in the third quarter. As an inbound to Brooke Coffey, now out to Alea Wilson. Wilson with a crossover, spin move, hangs and fires off the window, doesn't get it to go, but a foul is called. And again, Lindenwood finds their way to the free throw line, and that'll be Prince's third personal.
Yeah, Britt Prince just getting caught out of position there, and she'll take a seat. 3 fouls, only with 2 more to give, and still a lot of game left.
So Allison Widener, the junior, will check in for Prince as Leia Wilson finds herself at the line. And she misses the first on the season. Wilson, 100%, so that's the first free throw she's missed all year. Sophomore from Maple Grove, Minnesota. In Osseo High School, she splits the difference, goes 1 for 2, and we're all level at 34 here with 6 minutes to play in the third. Hake, she's got 10, leads all scorers in that category. Widener looking inside to Markowski, faces the double, quick skip pass. Nisley lines up the triple, bullseye! Logan Nisley establishes a 3-point advantage, and the Huskers lead over the Lions.
Markowski being double teamed in the lane gives Nisley a wide open shot there, and Markowski seeing that out of the corner of her eye, getting near the ball and giving her a chance.
As it's Wernley working against Widener, hounding her, trying to find some pressure. A handoff to Wernley, skip to Wilson, trying to drive against Hake. Huskers have tightened up defensively. Kelsey, short jumper, and she finds the range. Gracie Kelsey cuts the lead to 1.
Markowski, I think, was expecting Gracie Kelsey to travel farther into the lane, instead stays up top and sinks the short 2-pointer.
Kelsey at her first 3 of the season, now the 2, give her 5 on the day as the foul will go against Aleo Wilson. That will be her second personal as Jess Petrie checks in for Kendall Coley. Justice Odom comes back in to relieve Gracie Kelsey. Good minutes off the bench for Kelsey for a Lindenwood squad that's been able to find some offense and lock things down defensively so far.
Yeah, Kelsey, we saw her hit that 3 from the top of the key in the first half, and then transition to defense. She's really been berating Markowski, forcing her to play physical in the lane.
Good vocabulary there, using berating. Love the variance there. Nisley on the long pass, short jumper, and she's able to get it to rattle around and fall. Up, up, and around it goes, and the Huskers lead again by 3.
Amy Williams once said she thinks Logan Nisley's the best shooter in the country, and so if Nisley can get going from beyond the arc and maybe even a deep 2, Nebraska has a good chance here.
As a wrestling match on the floor will lead to a jump ball, as Markowski looked like she was going for a pin there for a second, came up shaking up on the finger. And so with that, we'll head to the media timeout. Huskers able to come from a 3 points down back to 3 points up. And coming up, we'll see if Lindenwood can find an answer. Hero Bank Arena, Huskers trying to shut down what's been a potent Lindenwood 3-point threat. 6 for 15 on the ballgame. That's good for 40%.
Yeah, Lindenwood not afraid to put those shots up. We've seen quite a few from deep, especially from Ellie Brueggemann. She's going to shoot over the top, quite a high shot from her. So she's able to clear that defender. And then Maya Scoff, the Nebraska native, hitting the 3 from the corner there.
That's a good thing to hit on. This Lindenwood squad from Texas, Oklahoma, and all around the Midwest. Feels like they have a player from every state in the Midwest except for Iowa. So a very solid recruiting ground established by Amy Egan in her second season at Lindenwood.
Yeah, able to recruit some players from all over the country and has a good mix of girls here fighting in this Nebraska game.
39-36, Nebraska restores the advantage over Lindenwood. 4:37 to play in the third quarter. Hakeoff the cut, gets that one swatted away from Odom. Markowski lines up the triple, and that one just left short. Nisley throws it off of Coffee, but somehow acrobatic move able to save it. Quickly turns it over. Widener up with a left hand, and she gets it to drop.
A lot going on down there under the basket. Nisley trying to throw it off Coffee. Coffee catches it. Then she tries to throw it off, and Allison Widener takes advantage of all the confusion and easy layup.
Scoff now to Odom as Lindenwood trying to fight their way back into this. Quick handoff to Wernley, trying to drive against Callen Hake. She's been stout defensively. Dump pass to Odom at the pinch post. Looking for an option, can't find one. 3 seconds left, just hoists one up and gets it to fall. A circus shot for Justice Odom as she cuts the lead to three. My goodness.
I wonder if her eyes were open on that one. Just kind of threw it up with one hand.
As Widener trying to drive Stong, yeah, felt like Odom just threw up a thought and a prayer and God answered it. Alea Wilson now with the ball as the Huskers come up empty offensively. Back cut, Wernley goes into the body of Markowski. Way too strong there. Good job by Markowski to go straight up and not draw the foul.
Yeah, Wernley not afraid to get in the lane with those big bodies, and Markowski did a good job keeping her cool, arms straight up, no foul.
Husker slow the tempo. Petrie looking for Markowski on the inside, backs it out to Hake. 10 to shoot on the shot clock as we tick under 3 minutes to play here in the third quarter. Hake tried to spin, and she's going to get called for a travel as she lost all the footing there.
Yeah, Hake looked to outlet pass there, got turned around and took a few too many steps and will get called for the travel.
Looked like she wanted to spin back, and in the end she ended up doing the reverse Macarena. 2 minutes, 56 seconds left to play here in the third as the Huskers lead by a triple. Rimdahl checks in for Hake, and Moriarty in as well, along with Petra Bojan. So a host of substitutions for the Huskers, as Alyssa Nielsen also checks in for the Lions. Brueggemann over to Scoff. Nada Nielsen. And Odom just hit the circus shot a couple of possessions ago. And now looking, directing traffic. Shot clock's down to 10. Nielsen looking for a way to the rim. Stops and finds a 12-foot jumper. That one too strong. Rebound by Rimdahl.
Good job by Rimdahl to stay around the basket. That ball bounced off the rim with some energy, and she was able to get a hand on it.
Bojan, quick pass to the inside. That one deflected away by Nielsen, working against Petrie. Possession will stay with the Huskers on the baseline. 2:28 to play.
Petrie working both sides of the lane here, and Petra Bojan trying to get it into her quickly. That ball was tipped by Lindenwood, so Nebraska regains possession.
And looks like we're going to have an offensive foul against Nebraska. It looks like Petra Bojan's going to get called there.
Yeah, Bojan playing physically as well with this Lindenwood team and gets called for the charge push off on the inbounding play.
They're just bumping bodies there with Odom, and a good sell right there for Odom as she got shoved on the interior. Always good to draw the official's attention. Odom on the handoff now for Scott. Now back up top to Brueggemann. She's been impressive. Three triples already tonight. Inside to Odom, working against the freshman Bojan. Odom, strong drive to the left hand. And she put a little bit too much mustard on the hot dog. And the rebound goes to Petrie. Up ahead to Moriarty as the Huskers try to reset offensively. Moriarty trapped in the corner. She needs some help. Reinforcements quickly arriving. Bojan back to the basket. Cut to Petrie. Right hand layup, and she kisses it off the window. Tough angle. Didn't matter for Jess Petrie.
Josh Petrie kind of bailing out Petra Bojan there. She had picked up her dribble, was looking for somewhere to go, and quick cut to the basket for two.
Nebraska's offense looking much more in system as this third quarter winds to a close. Lindenwood's got to find some offensive rhythm. They are on this 2 minute, 18 second scoring drought. Got to find a bucket. It's Scoff now over to Cunningham. Check back into the game. Odom fakes the handoff. Now up top to Nielsen, looking for Brueggemann off the screen. Quick touch pass inside to Odom, working against Bojan. That one tipped and knocked away. Petra Bojan picks up a block. As Nielsen launches the three and banks it in. My goodness, last second heroics from Alyssa Nielsen. Give that one a five for a Nielsen rating.
Yeah, Alyssa Nielsen knows she has no time, just has to put it up there and uses the backboard, banks it in.
Prince stop and pop answer. Bullseye for Britt Prince. As the Huskers restore the advantage to five.
Britt Prince with 8 points now. couple games in a row. She's been in the double digits. We'll see if she can get there again tonight.
Brueggemann now to Cunningham. She got rimmed on a bite on the fake. Inside to Odom. Fakes the handoff. Odom back to the basket. One-on-one with Bojan, and Petrie jumped into the lane. It wasn't a fair fight from the start. Huskers on the breakaway. 20 seconds. They'll slow it up and look to get the last shot. Odom thought she had the one-on-one, and Jess Petrie interrupted that festivity. 10 seconds left on the game clock here in the third quarter. Prince will stop and heave a triple. That one too strong, and a rebound tapped around and collected by Justice Odom. And she'll just hold it as the third quarter comes to an end. So Nebraska trailing by three out of the halftime locker room respond to go up five as we head into the fourth quarter here on Big Ten Plus. Five start of the fourth quarter. Let's kick it to the third member of our crew in just a moment. But first, Olivia, what a three-point barrage from the Huskers. They're able to hit three more and extend it to a five-point advantage.
Yeah, Nebraska struggled to shoot in the first half and on the inside game, and this half completely turned it around. We've seen quite a few shots from inside the lane and then beyond the three-point line as well.
Let's throw it over to the third member of our crew, Harmon Johnson, with a little bit on the Nebraska native, Maya Scoff. Harmon, what do you got?
Yeah, Justice, sorts for Lindenwood's Maya Scoff, the first D1 commit out of Bellevue East High School since Yvonne Turner committed to Nebraska back in 2006. Of course, Turner was a six-year WNBA vet with Phoenix for 6 years and then with the Seattle Storm. She was a dominant force in high school, averaged 17 points per game as a sophomore, 18 points per game as a junior, and had nearly 13,055 career points, shot 44% from the field. And she's averaging about 5.8 points off the bench this year in her second year at Lindenwood.
Well, thank you, Harmon. A tremendous job as we open the fourth quarter by our officiating crew, Natasha Kamey, Iffy Seals, and Jeff Cross, who have been managing the action tonight. Huskers open up the fourth quarter with a five-point advantage. Lindenwood has the ball. Alea Wilson in the corner, guarded by Petra Bojan. To Wernley, now to Brueggemann, over to Brooke Coffey. As Gracie Kelsey rounds out the starting five for Lindenwood. Coffey on the handoff, looking for an option, six to shoot. Lions have to get a shot up. Wilson looking for Wernley. Can't find an option, tries to force it through the arms of Moriarty, and she got a piece of it. Good stop by the Huskers. Here comes Prince, kick to the corner, rimmed off for three. Just a bit short. Rebound corralled by Petrie, and she taps it back up and in. How about the hustle from Jess Petrie?
Yeah, Petrie just crashing the lane and cleans it up there. Nice, easy ball just right over the rim.
Back to Alea Wilson, Justice Rohde, and Olivia Davenport bringing you the action as the Huskers trying to survive an early onslaught from the Lindenwood Lions out of St. Charles, Missouri. It's Gracie Kelsey over to Brooke Coffey. Back to Kelsey, hit her first three of the season tonight. Alea Wilson driving against Moriarty, and she came down and slapped Wilson on the shoulder. That'll send Wilson to the line for two shots.
Wilson, just good jab step there to get past Moriarty, and Moriarty trying to finish off with a block. Her arms come down right onto Wilson's arm.
Wilson missed a free throw earlier tonight. She's got 1 point, split the difference. She cans two. Played at Osseo, was an honorable mention All-State in high school, but didn't play a game last year for Lindenwood. Making an impact so far this game. As Wilson nets both of them and cuts the lead to five. Now into the offensive set for the Huskers. Moriarty to Petrie. Swing it over to Rimdahl, shooting an incredible clip from three this year. Moriarty into the lane, dumps it off to Bojan. Short jumper on the way. Bingo for Petra Bojan. And she finds another one, and the Huskers lead by seven.
Good eyes by Moriarty. Bojan just shagging off outside the lane. Her defender stayed in the lane and gave her an easy two.
Brueggemann will heave the triple. That one too strong. Rebound for Kelsey. Turnaround left hook is up and good. Gracie Kelsey with 7 points off the bench for the Lions. Now to Rimdahl. Quick dump pass inside to Petrie, looking for a cutting Britt. Prince up with a right hand and couldn't quite get it to fall, but gets a consolation prize of two shots at the free throw line.
For Prince, so good at cutting to the basket and helping her teammates out when they're in trouble. Petrie looking to dish it out there, and Prince comes in, one dribble, and couldn't get it to fall, but we'll go to the line for two.
So Britt Prince, the standout freshman for Nebraska, 8 points, 3 for 6 from the field tonight, one rebound. is the number 28 player in the nation, according to ESPN.
Yeah, Prince wears her hair down, which you might think is a fashion statement, but there's actually a story. Her friend got hit in the face at a softball game the first time she wore her hair up to a competitive game, and ever since then, she's worn it down.
A very touching story there. She goes 1-for-2 at the line. Huskers lead by 6 as Moriarty hits a deck on a nasty move from Wilson, and then a return to sender. Markowski says, get that weak stuff out of here.
Yeah, Markowski turns and looks at Moriarty. I got you. And that's that good help defense communication that Amy Williams has been asking of her team this year.
Another block for Markowski. She averages 0.7 a game. That'll add to the total. Scoff on the wing. Back up top to Alea Wilson. And Wilson looking for help. Finds her way to Scoff. Two-person game there. Now to Brueggemann. She's been the leading scorer. Up off the right hand and no good. And a rebound fought for. A tussle underneath between Odom and Petrie. And the possession's going to go to Nebraska. So Petrie ends up getting the better of that exchange.
Petrie going up and getting it. Not shying away from Justice Odom at all, who had pretty decent position, but Petrie just fighting through that.
That's the effort plays that Amy Williams wanted to see after the loss to Creighton. Thought they could have caught a couple extra possessions. And a Moriarty up top to Petrie. Hand off to Moriarty. A ball screen, and Britt Prince goes right to work on Alea Wilson. Stop and pop jumper for Prince. That one too strong. And the rebound for Brooke Coffey as Markowski takes a tumble into a row of cheerleaders. Long three, Scoff lines it up and can't bank it home with a rebound for Brueggemann. As they pass it around, Scoff lines it up a bit too strong again, and a loose ball is corralled. What effort from Maya Scoff, and the jump ball is going to keep possession with Lindenwood. A mad dash to the ball, and Maya Scoff won the race.
Yeah, Maya Scoff finding the rebound of her own shot the second time around, and just trembling in there. Alberti Rimdahl looks like she had it, and Scoff just comes running in and breaks up the ball.
On the jump ball, possession stays with Lindenwood. They're 0 for their last four. Haven't seen a field goal fall in a bit. They're trailing by 6. Desperately need to see one go in. Right to Brooke Coffey. Good help from Markowski. Turnaround jumper doesn't matter. Brooke Coffey with a fadeaway to cut it to 4.
The up and over from Coffey. Little spin move and got it over the defender in Markowski.
It's Britt Prince looking for Callen Hake. Screen from Petrie. Hake bumps out, looking for a passing option. Great defense by Lindenwood. Nisley, looked like she dribbled that one off the foot of Scoff. Nisley gets it back, kick save and a beauty, but it's going to go to Lindenwood. Only viable in the sport of soccer there, Olivia.
And volleyball.
And volleyball. You can kick the ball in volleyball. Nonetheless, this is basketball, and Logan Nisley has the ball turned over.
Amy Williams visibly upset with the call.
And we got a traveling violation against Alea Wilson. She's wondering what she did. Might have been a makeup call there, Olivia.
Yeah, I think the kick call was off the foot of Logan Nisley, just about 10 seconds too late for Amy Williams' liking, I think.
And here's Nisley inbounds to Prince. 6:28 left to play in the ball game. Nebraska trying to protect a 4-point advantage against Lindenwood. Inside it goes to Markowski working against Odom. She's been quiet in the scoring column. Markowski on the step through with the left hand and good. How about Alexis Markowski with 5 points on the day?
Yeah, Markowski really working the lane. Left, right, left again, then back to the right side and got it to fall this time.
Good footwork. Brueggemann hides on the fade play. That one to the right of the rim. No good. Odom grabs it, just threw it up. I'm going to wait and see if this was a shooting foul, but nonetheless, great effort by Justice Odom. She's been battling on the inside against Markowski all evening.
Yeah, Markowski just failing to get position, didn't find a body, was just standing in free space, and Justice Odom charged towards the basket, got that rebound, and then got a foul.
So lo and behold, Justice Odom's going to get 2 shots at the free throw line here, and Amy Williams can't be happy at the lack of a box out. Odom at the line, an 80% free throw shooter from Indianapolis, Indiana, and she misses the first. Played 27 games last year, started 25 before she played at Lindenwood, was at Texas A&M Corpus Christi. 23 games, 6 rebounds on the ball game for Justice Odom. She's been battling on the glass.
Fighting against one of the top rebounders at Nebraska, Alexis Markowski. So Justice Odom playing physical and going to get that ball.
Odom splits the difference against reinforcements. Gracie Kelsey is given good minutes and 7 points off the bench. She gets back into the ballgame for some more action. 5:55 left to play as Nebraska leads over Lindenwood 53-48. Prince with the ball at the top of the key, working against Alea Wilson. Over it goes to Hake, inside to Markowski. She's doubled immediately. Doesn't matter. Step through up with the left hand, and she'll draw the contact and the foul.
Markowski doing a good job fighting through about 3 defenders there. And couldn't get it to fall, but she'll head to the line.
And Gracie Kelsey picks up her 3rd personal. And Markowski at the line, struggling from the free throw stripe today. Only 1 for 5. And she's able to get the hometown bounce. The Lincoln Pius X graduate able to kiss that one home and extend the Husker advantage to a 7-point lead. And she gets both of them. That's the pair, and Markowski has Nebraska up to an 8-point advantage and an immediate trap for Nebraska. Lindenwood able to break it as it goes to Wernley and now to Wilson. Lions able to avoid the pressure momentarily. Out it goes to Nielsen, heavily pressured by Nisley to the pinch post for Kelsey. Looking for a handoff for Wilson. She waits, able to spin her way through Hake and tried to force it up just short. Rebound for Markowski. There was a lot of hands in the lane. Foul will go against Gracie Kelsey. That's her 4th. And with that, Alexis Markowski moves her way up to 1,020 rebounds. And that puts her at 5th on the all-time list for career rebounds at Nebraska.
Markowski earlier this season topped the double-double list with 43 is the new record she holds, and making her way up on the rebounds.
Continuing to add to her Nebraska legacy. To Nisley on the fade play. Skip to the corner. Prince tries the triple. Bullseye! Britt Prince cans another 3, and Nebraska's opened up a 10-point advantage.
Natalie Potts liked that one from Britt Prince, giving us a little dance over on the bench.
Here's Scoff. She's heavily pressured, and she took a couple tap dancing lessons, looks like. Another travel for Lindenwood. Give them 18 turnovers on the ball game.
Yeah, and then the pressure from Nebraska getting to Lindenwood late in the game. Nebraska with a 10-point lead now.
Nebraska with a 10-point lead coming up. We'll see if Lindenwood can cut it back or if Nebraska can open up even more.
finalists. Markowski is on the watch list for the Naismith and Wooden Awards. Now with that 1,020 rebounds, Markowski sits behind Janet Smith, Emily Cady, and Jordan Hooper for the women's list. Justice.
Thank you, Harmon. And Alexis Markowski already set the double-double mark, and she continues to add to an impressive resume, Olivia, in her 4 years at Nebraska.
Yeah, Markowski, always been a dream to play at Nebraska. Her dad played here, and as she continues to build her legacy 4 years later, what a great career.
So out of the timeout, Huskers lead this one 58-48 over Lindenwood. Got a scare early, trailed by three in the halftime locker room. But now they've opened it up to a double-digit lead. Inside it goes to Markowski off the feed from Prince. Up top to Hake, drives in, dishes it to Markowski, working against Odom. Fade away, and she's able to get it to drop. What a shot from Alexis Markowski as the Huskers lead by 12.
Yeah, war of attrition down there in the lane between Justice Odom and Alexis Markowski. Markowski topping her a few in the last few possessions here.
Up to 9 points. Huskers on a 7-0 run over the last minute and 15. Up to 4 minutes to play now in the game as Aleo Wilson faces a double. Gets it over. And a wild shot there from Gracie Wernley. Skip pass ahead from Kendall Coley. It was a beauty. Nisley stop and pop triple, left it too strong. Rebound.
Nisley just a little too open there, I think. Thought about passing it to Callen Haken, decided to take it herself. Gave herself too much time to think about it.
Brueggemann to Odom at the top of the key. Now kicks it. Wernley tries a triple. And just in and out. Looked like she had it going, and then it rimmed out. Rebound to Markowski. Here's Hake. Skip pass, and it's tipped away momentarily for Wernley. Hake stop and pop. Inside it goes to Coley, and she lost the handle on it, and it trickles out of bounds.
Kendall Coley unable to hold on to that ball, was open and probably had an easy layup left before the ball got to her.
There's Wernley. Now 3 minutes and 10 seconds left to play. Huskers five of their last seven. Lindenwood hasn't scored in 2 minutes, 35 seconds. One of their last nine from the field. Odom over to Wernley will try another triple. That one way off. Could see it right off the hand. It wasn't going to find the rim.
Plenty of time in there for Grace Wernley, just trying to get her team back into this game with a quick three. She'll sub out. Maya Scoff will sub in.
Maya Scoff, hometown story from just up the road on I-80, Bellevue East High School in Bellevue, Nebraska. Great insight earlier from Harmon on her. Swung around to Logan Nisley. 5-0 scoring run the last 2 minutes. Coley makes it 8-0. How about Kendall Coley responding from the mistake and finding a triple? Huskers lead 63-48.
Kendall Coley coming hard off that screen, gets her shoulders square to the basket, sinks one.
And a back cut there. Odom, nifty pass to the inside. Boy, what a feed from Justice Odom. That was a tight window, and she was able to open it.
Yeah, I thought Kellen Hake did pretty decent job sticking with Maya Scoff, but Justice Odom tried to thread the needle, and Callen Hake got caught up.
Tried to thread the pass to Maya Scoff. Huskers on a 10-0 run over the last 3 minutes, 6 seconds. 12-1 over the last 3 minutes and 39. As Coffey spins, that one's rejected by Markowski. She wasn't going to fall for the same trick twice. Another block for Alexis Markowski, and the Huskers still leading 63-48, 2 minutes and 12 seconds to play in the game. Four blocks for Alexis Markowski. It's a block party for her and Lincoln. Hard screen as Prince got drilled in the nose. Coley inside, great positioning for Markowski, the pirouette, and the perfect placement off the backboard for two.
Yeah, and that pass finally working. For Nebraska, we saw Logan Nissi try it a couple times in the first half, and Kendall Coley was able to hit the target.
Up top to Scoff, into the wing for Coffey. Now back to Scoff. Over to Aleo Wilson, and a third straight double-double for Alexis Markowski, 11-11 with four blocks. As Wilson tried to sneak that one away, strong rebound for Hake. Here come the Huskers in transition, and Hake will just back it out and reset the offense.
Great, strong rebound by Callen Hake.
And a feed inside. Coley missed the bunny, and she missed the reverse. Prince able to find an easy two. Britt Prince with a short jumper.
Kendall Coley, a couple rebounds there.
And here's Hake trying to go up strong with that right hand and make it a quick 4-0 run for the Huskers. Give them a 16-0 run over the last 4 minutes and 35 seconds. 18-1 over the last 5 minutes. A complete scoring domination in the final five for the Big Red.
And that's that aggressive defense transitioning to offense, and they're finishing those shots, finishing those layups earlier in the first half. We were seeing them kind of go short off the rim, too hard off the backboard, and this time they really focused in. Made those layups.
So a host of subs for the Huskers. Bojan, Widener, and Rimdahl all check in for Markowski, Nisley, and Prince. Prince will have to wait another night on her chase to 100 points. She's at 99. And a quick over to Brueggemann. Lets the triple fly. That one too strong, and a shove in the back. That's going to be a block in the back in football, illegal in volleyball, and certainly illegal in basketball.
Yeah, all over the place. I think Maya Scoff just came in too hard and caught the back of Callen Haake. Callen Haake ready for the ball. Maya Scoff a little bit out of control there.
Our great Big Ten Plus crew also informed me that that would be a yellow card in soccer. So a foul in multiple sports from Maya Scoff. Across the board. An international incident, we would say. 69-48. Pretty nice score for the Huskers as they lead 36 seconds left to play. Coley lines up the triple. She doesn't care. Almost cans another. And that rebound falls into the hands of Alea Wilson. Both teams in the bonus really won't matter with 25 seconds left to play. This affair is all but wrapped up. Brueggemann driving into the lane. Skip pass. Scoff lines up the triple. And a bit too strong for everything, but a rebound to Brueggemann. Back to Scoff. Tries a second time. Again rolls around the rim, can't get it to go. Boy, it looks like the lid's on the rim for Maya Scoff over her last four from downtown.
Got Maya Scoff close all four times, unable to sink it.
Well, Lindenwood led at halftime by